But Pankaj, we have a new debutant on the Lal Street, Varroc Engineering, and here's Tarang Jain, the managing director, joining us. Mr. Jain, congratulations on making your debut at the primary markets, being a formal member now of the Lal Street. Look at your intraday chart. Let's bring it up for you. Right now, the stock is up almost 5%. Did you expect this kind of a response, particularly from the institutional investors?
Yeah, you know, I did expect a good response from the FIIs and the funds. The reason is that, you know, we were closely interacting with them all throughout, you know, and I would say that we listened to them, you know, we listened to what they had to say. So when it came to valuations, we did something which, you know, they were comfortable with. So we were quite expecting this kind of a demand, you know, from the FII and the domestic fund side.
Yeah, but you know, look at the gap up. You first saw a gap down on trade, and then we saw that big spike coming in. You're 6% in the green as we speak. You know, you've also given your investors an exit via the offer for sale. So tell me, how much cash are you left with? What are your plans for deploying it? This is a big thumbs up you're getting from the Lal Street.
No, so this 15%, you know, which we have diluted. You know, the main reason is that, you know, the PE firm Tata Opportunity Fund is exiting. You know, so they have a 13.7% stake. So it's basically to give them an exit, and then there's a secondary sale, you know, by me, you know, of about 1.3%. So at the moment there's nothing really coming into the company because, you know, we have, you know, a strong net debt to equity position. You know, we're at about 0.3, you know, and we are pretty confident that, you know, going forward, all our expansions, whatever we are doing in the coming years, could, you know, would be managed through the internal generations. That's the reason we have not gone for a primary at present. But going forward, you know, with we have another 10% to dilute, you know, in the coming 3 years. So we are looking at some M&A activity, and if there is a larger acquisition we can identify, we could go in for a primary, you know, issue. But that would be more for an M&A kind of an activity, not really for organic growth.
Right, sir, can you talk more about this investment into partnership? Are you in talks with anyone? Can you give more details about this inorganic growth?
See, presently, you know, we have just completed an acquisition in Turkey. You know, it's a smaller company, about 40-50 million euros. You know, that gives us access to the 1.7 million car market. But other than that, you know, we are still, you know, searching for acquisitions. You know, and we don't know, we don't have another acquisition at the moment, you know, where we can say, yeah, we've identified this one, which we are going to go after.
Can you talk to us about how big is your PV business overall, looking at expanding in India? What's the presence currently in that segment?
Yeah, so we are. So basically, see, the passenger vehicle, you know, segment for us is probably 63-64%, largely because, you know, of our exterior lighting business, you know, because that is itself 61%. So in India, you know, basically only 10% of our revenues are in the car segment, where we play in a few products like, you know, some engine transmission parts, you know, and also the plastic interiors for cars. That's something which is kind of growing well. But having said that, you know, our focus in India would be more the two and three wheeler parts business, and also, you know, to grow, you know, in the lighting market in India, because, you know, the lighting market for cars is, for the last 5 or 6 years, it's not been a very big focus for us, you know. So we've only been dealing with a few customers we have today, but now going forward, you know, that's the area we want to grow in India, on the lighting segment for cars. So that's something which will be a focus, you know. Other than that, I think our core businesses are in the two and three wheeler segment in India.
And Mr. Jain, what's the capacity levels that you're currently operating at? You're going to have all of this cash. You've got proceeds in the IPO. So what kind of expansion have you lined up, especially for the R&D?
So I think overall, we would be close to about 75%, you know, and on a global basis, you know, we do spend about 700-800 crores on our capex, what we've been doing. And that's something organically for organic growth. And we've been growing at 20% CAGR the last 5 years, and that's something at least we will want to continue. That's a kind of a capex which I think will continue, you know, in the coming years also.
In terms of margins and sale, what are the long-term targets that you have?
Yeah, we do have actually. I can't share it with you, but I can just say that we are in a good place, and we are definitely kind of going to have. We are definitely going to be growing our margins. I think margin growth also happens largely more with revenue growth, and that's something we are, which will happen going forward. Our India business, anyway, we are at about at a certain double-digit kind of margin. It's a lighting business which is at a little lower margin, about 8.5%. So that's something, we have to get into double digits. Well, that's very much on our mind, so it's margins, and also equally important is our return on capital employed. We have, that's something we have an internal target of 20, and that's something we are going to maintain going forward, whatever the growth may be.
Right, Mr. Jain, here's wishing you all the very best. Congratulations on your listing on the Lal Street. We look forward to more interactions in the future.